So today I'm back here at Kevin's, the largest stingray breeder in the United States. But today, I want to know how all of this works. What are you running for filtration? How do you take care of these tanks? What's it like for water changes? And of course, what are we feeding these guys? There's so many different types of systems in here. You got the adults out there breeding, you got the pups in here growing out. They're not all run the same, are they?
No, they're not. With the pups, I like to have individual systems, only because when they're young, you need to pay more attention to them. They're a little bit more sensitive, so I need a more controlled environment. So with the pup systems, I have an overhead filtration box, custom designed, where I have a power head pumping it up from the tank, goes through the box, through your typical media pad, and then through the biological and back down. It's really a very basic and simple setup, nothing crazy or elaborate.
You built those yourself?
Yes.
Awesome.
You know, you can use canister filters, but I like stuff that's easy access. I can get right to the filter pad, take it out, throw in a new pad, and you know, my maintenance is done, and I'm sure that the filter is clean.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So how do you perform water changes on here? It looks like you have a setup of PVC pipes.
Yeah. When you get to such a large scale, you can't go with your typical hose sucking into a bucket and dumping it, which is what I used to do. We all paid our dues doing that, I'm sure, you know, getting the carpets all wet. But what I do now is I have a drain on the tank with a valve that I can open, and it will drain out through a main sewer line. All the tanks are connected in the same way to a main sewer line, and then I run another line of clean water, which is this line here. It's connected to my water reserve tank. I have a reserve tank that fills 2,000 gallons overnight, so I have 2,000 gallons of water for me every day. And to fill it, just open the valve and water just comes into the tank, and that's how I do the water changes. So I just work my way one tank at a time. I can do this whole room maybe in about like 30 minutes.
And obviously you're keeping bare bottom in all of your tanks, I think, except one. I've seen a little bit of sand. I also do bare bottoms with rays and certain types of fish. Why do you do it?
It's cleaner. You know, I'm trying to keep the environment as clean as possible, especially since I would consider most of my tanks are quite overcrowded. So to me, number one is keeping it as clean as possible. So the absence of gravel or sand will help that, because a lot of times stuff and debris can get trapped underneath.
Right.
So, yeah, I'm more of a cleanliness type of guy.
Right. Yeah. So that's how you run the pup tanks. Mm-hmm. What do you feed these guys?
A number of things. I usually start them off with night crawlers. I'll chop them up into small bits. Shrimp, same thing, chop them up into small bits. Silver sides. I try to get them onto a variety of food at an early age. It just makes it easier for you when you get the fish as well, you know, to be able to adapt them to whatever food you're comfortable with. Mm-hmm. Only thing I don't do is pellets, which I do get a lot of people asking me why I don't do that. But I just prefer a clean, natural source of food, nothing artificial.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. So let's move on to the big guys, the breeding area, I guess.
Okay. Hey. So in here, my breeders, this was the first system I set up when we built this facility, and it's a centralized system. All the tanks are linked together, and it comes back to one central filter system, which is a fluidized bed filter. It's a moving bed K1.
Yeah.
And from there, it goes through a big canister filter and then back to the tanks.
And they're all kind of run on the same systems. What are these big blocks up top? That's the heater?
Yeah, that's a heat pump.
The heat pump. So it heats the area?
No, it heats the water. It's kind of like a reversed air conditioner.
Ah.
So it draws the heat from the room and puts it back into the water. It's supposed to be really energy efficient, and I believe it is because my electric bill has come down so much since I started using these things. But sometimes people find it kind of weird because they say, oh, it uses electricity, so shouldn't it you be using a lot? But it doesn't generate the heat. It draws the heat from the surrounding area and puts it into the water.
Right.
Yeah. In this filtration system, this was my next filtration system, which I improved upon from my original one to add a very powerful mechanical filter, which is a rotary drum filter. It's used by koi people and by chemical filtration, water filtration companies. It's water that passes through this drum, which is has a stainless steel mesh that captures all the mechanical debris,
right,
and it cleans itself automatically. It has float valve sensors in there, so when it gets clogged, it will clean. So now, no more cleaning dirty socks, changing the pads, getting all disgusting. So it's quite nice.
Awesome. Water changes out here. Are they? It looks like they're pretty similar to the pup tanks.
No, on my bigger systems, I do a constant drip.
Ah, drip systems, right?
Yes, it's a drip system. So water comes in through a carbon filter, heated, and it enters into the tanks. So it comes in and drips out. So both my breeding systems are that way.
Right. And what do you feed these guys? Same idea, just bigger sizes?
Yep, no chopping. I just feed them the whole shrimp, silver sides, night crawlers. That's the general mix of stuff that I feed all my fish.
Okay. Yeah. We have the other side. Yeah, so this little area seems to be a little more unique as well. You got some canister filters running.
Yes, here nothing is centralized. Everything is individual.
Okay.
Same thing, allows me to have flexibility. The filtration here is basically canisters on every tank. Water changes, I drain it and fill it whenever I backflush. I backflush it once a week, drain out about 50%. And I have water line coming in from my reserve tank again that will pump the water back in.
And the diet here in here is the same as well.
Yeah.
This is more of an importing room, do you find? Like you more imported razor in here?
Yeah, more of my newer stuff, the exotic stuff, because I like to keep things separated. So my breeding collection stays on one side, and then whatever new coming into the facility or anything that I need more control of, it'll come into this room where they go into separate systems of tanks.
Right.
So you're in here pretty much every day working on the tanks, you're feeding, cleaning, mm-hmm. all for what? You sell these guys, right?
Yes. Yes. Right. We're a commercial breeder, so I'm here 9 in the morning till about 6 at night, and it's just fish every day.
And how does somebody buy these rays from you?
You can contact me through Facebook messaging, and I'll answer you within 24 hours, and you let me know what you want.
What do they look up?
You look up Kevin Stingray Biology on Facebook.
Right. Yeah. Okay. I'll leave a link in the description, you guys, to check them out. So that seems like it's about it. Everything is it's uniquely set up. A lot of automation here. The focus here, obviously, is to make it as easy as possible.
Yes, yes. Try to save time, get things done in a quick and efficient manner.
Right. What is, like, your favorite, your ideal setup for a stingray tank?
Ideal setup for me is a combination of very good mechanical and moving bed filtration. You can see an example of it right here. Where the water draws from the tank to a canister filter, which I use it mainly for mechanical. And then from here, it would pump up into this tank here where we have the biological, which is the moving bed. I favor the moving bed because you never have to clean it. It's pretty much self-cleaning. No debris gets trapped in there. So I never have to clean my filter.
Okay. So water changes, do you prefer manual water changes or drip?
I have it's set up for both.
You set up for both?
Yes.
And how often do you feed them? Obviously, it's going to vary based on size, but you got some monster rays, and then you got like a bunch of pups.
Everyone gets fed minimum once a day, and time permitting, I might go back and feed some of the younger ones twice a day.
Okay. And they all look absolutely healthy, nice and fat. Well, that once again, this has been an amazing journey to a day in your life, behind the scenes of how it all works. I certainly appreciate it. And I know everybody at home watching also appreciates it. So thanks for having us.
No problem. Thank you for being here.